Hello everyone, this is Tejashree here. Today we are going to see the last special case of assignment problem, that is prohibited assignments. Before starting with this, I just want to inform you all that very soon I'll be uploading few videos on aptitude also, because those would be useful to those people who are preparing for various competitive exams and all. And I myself have cracked IBPS SO and PO, so, and I had a good hand in aptitude and reasoning. So I really think sharing that knowledge plus a few tricks would be really useful for those who are preparing. So just keep watching, and if any suggestions are there, you're most welcome. So let's get started with this video now. So prohibited assignment means what? That you will come to know very soon. Let's directly jump to the example. So this is the example given to us, in which 4 clocks are given and 4 jobs are given. Let's assume this scenario as typical banking scenario, in where 4 clocks are working ABCD, okay, and let's assume that this job or this department, job number 2 or department number 2, is of loan section. Let's assume that. And let's say this clerk number C is a cashier, or the person who sits in the cash window. So this person won't be able to perform this job for sure, loan job for sure. Why? Because maybe because he has never worked in that section, or maybe because he is fully busy with cash department only. So this clerk won't be able to perform this job number 2 anyways. And this is known as prohibited assignment, where the assignments are not allowed. This is the typical practical scenario. Wherever you go in any industry, this is not possible that everything can be performed by everyone. So there will be some restrictions, and those restrictions we are going to see in this particular case, in this topic. So the assignments which cannot be made will be indicated by dash or cross, and these are known as prohibited assignments, means not allowed assignments. Okay, now we are going to solve this by using Hungarian method only. There are two basic criteria of Hungarian method. First is balanced matrix and minimization type of matrix. The matrix is balanced. Yes, it is 4 by 4 matrix, so it is balanced. Second criteria, it should be of minimization type. Is it? Yes, these numbers are indicating time numbers, which means that clerk A can perform job number 3 in 8 minutes and so on. So this is time which we always try to minimize, and hence it is of minimization type of matrix. Both the criteria are fulfilled here. Now we can directly start solving it, but before that, look at these numbers where the assignments just cannot made. Okay, just cannot be made. So in those cases, just remember basic things, like when the matrix is of minimization type, you have to replace these dash or cross with plus infinity, and when the matrix is of maximization type, you have to replace those with minus infinity. Now this is logical. You just you don't have to mug it up. This is logical. It makes sense. How? Just see here. Minimization, this is our minimization matrix, so replace those dash with plus infinity here and here at these two places. Okay, whenever we get solution of this, what would be the final solution? Time required, right, which we always try to minimize. But these numbers are infinite numbers. Plus infinity means some very huge numbers, and therefore we are never going to make any allocations there. Why? Because those are very huge numbers, some plus infinite numbers. And exact opposite with the maximization problem, where we try to find out the maximum solution. For example, when profit figures are given to you, you always try to maximize the profit. But in that case, you are replacing those dash or prohibited assignments with minus infinity, which means again, those are very small numbers which you cannot make allocations at. So this is how you are supposed to make the or replace the dash or crosses given to you. So here, for sure, you have replaced those with plus infinity. Now, both the criteria are fulfilled. You have replaced. Now, you can directly start solving it by using Hungarian method. First step is row subtraction, then column subtraction. Let's go for row subtraction. Smallest number is 4. So, subtract that from all the numbers in that row. 4 minus 4 is 0. 7 minus 4 is 3. 8 minus 4, 4. 6 minus 4. 2. I hope you are able to see this. Now here the smallest number is 4, so you are going to subtract that. Infinity minus 4, infinity minus anything, infinity plus anything would be infinity only. So it would be infinity only. Now 8 minus 4 is 4, 7 minus 4 is 3, 4 minus 4 is 0. Third row, 3 is the smallest number, 3 minus 3 is 0, infinity minus 3 again infinity, 8 minus 3 5, 3 minus 3 0. In last row, 2 is the smallest number, 6 minus 2 4, 6 minus 2 again 4, 4 minus 2 2, 2 minus 2 0. So this is your row subtraction. Now let's go for column subtraction. In first column, 0 is there, so there won't be any change in that column. 0, infinity, 0 and 4. In second column, the smallest number is 3, so subtract 3. 3 minus 3, 0, 4 minus 3, 1, infinity minus 3, infinity, 4 minus 3, 1. Okay, in third column, the smallest number is 2, so 4 minus 2 is 2, 3 minus 2 is 1, 5 minus 2 is 3, 2 minus 2 is 0. Okay, and in last column, 0 is there, so copy that column as it is, 0, 0, 0. Okay. So, this is column subtraction and this matrix is reduced matrix. Okay. Now, let's draw the minimum number of lines to cover all the zeros. So, let's see here row wise 2 zeros 1, 2, 2. If you go column wise 2, here 1, 1 and 3. In last column there are 3 zeros. So, cover that first. Again go row wise 2, no 0, 1, 1. Column wise 2, 1, 1. So, 2 zeros are there. You are going to cover that first. Now, see, there are 2 zeros. So, if you go anyways, you are going to require 2 lines for sure. So, here 4 number of lines, minimum 4 number of lines are required to cover all these zeros, which is equal to n. What is our n? N is here 4, 4 by 4 matrix, right? So, here lies your solution for sure. You just have to make the allocations now. For that purpose, we will copy this matrix as it is. 0, 0, 2, 2. In second row, infinity, 1, 1, 0. Then 0, infinity, 3, 0. And last row, 4, 1, 0, 0. Okay. So, this is the matrix where your solution is there. Now, let's make allocations. Let's go row wise. Wherever you see single 0, there you are going to make allocation. In first row, there are 2 zeros. In second row, there is only 1 zero. So, there you are going to make allocation for sure. These would be crossed. In third row, now there is only 1 zero. Make allocation there. This would be crossed. In D, there is 1 zero. Make allocation there. No any zero in that column. Now in A, there is only 1 zero. So, make allocation there. Okay. This is how the allocations are made. Now, let's tabulate the solution. This process is same, just you have to understand where to put plus infinity, where minus infinity. Okay, now let's tabulate this. These four clerks, A, B, C, D and four jobs. So, A will perform job number 2, B will perform job 4, C will perform job 1 and D will perform job 3. Okay, and then you will get the, you will find these numbers from the original matrix which is given to us, time required. So, A, 2. A2 is 7, B4, B4 is 4, C1, C1 is 3 and D3, D3 is 4. Okay? Okay. So, this would be the total time required to perform this full activity, which is minimum time. How much is that? 18. Okay, and as we have seen, these are in minutes. So, 18 minutes are required to perform these all four jobs by all these four clerks, which is the smallest amount of time. Okay, and if you have noticed, C is not allotted to job 2, C has been not allotted job 2 and B has been not allotted job 1. See here, right? Those won't be allotted because we are replacing those with infinity, some large numbers. So, this is how the prohibited assignment matrix can be solved. Now, I have written down one more example here for your reference. I'll just show you the first step, how to replace this with infinity, and then you can start solving it. You can solve it at home as your homework again. So this is the example given to you, okay, where five pilots are there, some airline is there basically, okay, newly started airline where five pilots they have recruited, and these are five flight numbers, okay, and now these numbers are indicating the preferences given by pilot, okay. So pilot and these preferences lie from 1 to 10, 10 being the highest preference. So A gives 8 preference, means much higher preference, to flight number A. A gives 2 preference, lower preference, to flight number 2. A gives no preference at all to flight number 3, so on. And these numbers are preferences, which means this is of maximization type of problem, because we always will try to maximize the preferences or go with the preferences of pilots to make them happy, to make your staff happy and satisfied. So this is of maximization type of problem. Now you have to convert it into the minimization type of problem. But before that, what we have seen, the restricted assignments would be replaced with minus infinity. Okay, as this is of maximization type, these two places you are going to replace with minus infinity. Okay, now this is balanced matrix, but it is of maximization type, so you have to convert it into the minimization type. So for that, what do? You find out the largest number in that matrix and subtract all the numbers from that number to convert it into the minimization regular assignment problem. Okay, so what is the largest number here? 10. 10 being the highest preference, so 10 is the maximum number. So you are going to subtract all the elements from this 10. So 10 minus 8, 10 minus 2. Here, 10 minus, see carefully, 10 minus minus infinity. Okay, 10 minus this number minus infinity, which is nothing but what? 10 minus minus will be plus infinity. Infinity plus anything will be infinity only, right? So, when this matrix will be converted into the minimization matrix, automatically this place will become plus infinity, which is here, plus infinity, which we require in case of minimization problem. Okay, so this is, and you just try solving this at home. I've just given you the hint how to get started with this, and I'll also upload its solution in the description box. I hope the concept is clear. I have in total uploaded 6 videos of assignment problem. So I really recommend to watch all of those videos. The 4 videos are of exceptional cases and 2 videos are the basic examples of assignment problem, like basic flow of Hungarian method. So if you watch all of those 6 videos, there won't be any query, or I bet there won't be any problem that you won't be able to solve by using Hungarian method. So just keep watching one by one all the videos for your better understanding, and thank you so much. I really hope you understood the concept very well. Just keep commenting whatever your queries are. I will try to respond to those as well. Thank you so much.